Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we will have a very common and basic React interview question, that is the accordion. So as you can see, we have the accordion. It means we have our main data, that is the reactjs, next.js and simply node.js, and we also have a plus button. So if I click this plus button, see, we will see the details about the reactjs. And the plus symbol also got changed to minus symbol. And if again I click this, again it will collapse. Again we will see a plus symbol with the reactjs data simply. It means in our first click, it is simply expanding and showing details about the data, that is next.js. And again on the second click, again it is collapsing. So how you will create this accordion? So let's dive into our code straight away. So as always, I already have the CSS for this, and I also have the data, like the main data and then the subdata, which consists of the details about this. So it's always a good practice to have your data in a separate file, as here I have created a separate file, that is data.js simply. So let's just create the layout first. And let's import our data and the CSS for this. So simply our main data and then our subdata, then simply our CSS file, that is accordion.css simply. So here what we need to do, simply on our first click we need to change this conditionally to minus symbol, and we need to show the data. And on the second click, again we need to change this minus symbol to plus, and again we need to hide this data, right? So in our click, first click, we will change this conditionally and show our data conditionally as well. So first let us have our state variable. So let's import our useState hook. Then simply have our state variable. So let's give the name of our state variable as active field, and the function which will update the value of state variable, simply set active field. So initially it would be simply null. So why null? I will show you. So I'll be using React fragments. Then we need to have this data, right? So let us do one thing, simply first let us have our data. It means let us initially show all our data, like the main data and subdata, and initially with a plus symbol only, that is this. Later on we will add the functionalities. So, and to have our data, we will use a map method, as instead of writing this one by one, we will use a map method which will create an array of our data for us. So simply our main data dot map and the first parameter would be simply data and the second id. So here our whole data will get stored, like main data, and we also need id, right? Then simply we will have a div. So let's give the class name as accordion container, and whenever you will use a map method, always have a key prop with the id. Then simply first simply show your data, and let's have one heading as accordion simply. And here simply our data. So see, we have our data initially, and then simply have a button. Let's say initially simply have this plus button, and also have your subdata. So see, initially we have our main data as well as our subdata, with a plus symbol. Now we will add the functionalities. So what we need to do, we need to change this conditionally with plus to minus, and then we need to conditionally show or hide our data. So we will do this with the help of ID. And the main thing would be simply what we will do, at the first click, we will set the ID to this active field, which will be our state variable. And on the second click, we will again set it back to null. It means on our first click, this active field will be holding the ID. And in our second click, this active field will hold simply null. So don't worry about this. This I will show you. So we want to change this conditionally on our click, right? So obviously we need to have an onClick event handler. So simply the function name as handleClick. And what we need to do, whichever button we will click, like the React button, like this button, Next.js button, Node.js button, we will want to have the ID. So if I click React.js button, the ID would be 0, and for Next.js ID 1, and similarly for Node.js ID would be 2. So here on clicking this, we need to pass the ID. So handle click simply ID, and then we need to define this function, that is handle click. So simply handle click. Then here we will pass the ID. It means whichever button we will click, we will grab their ID and we will have their ID here. So let me show you first. So let me show you this. So if I click this React.js, the ID should be 0. And for Next.js, 1 simply. And for Node.js, 2. So see, we are getting the ID, right? So the main thing lies here only in the ID part. So now we have the ID. So what we need to do with the ID? So simply 0, 1 and 2. And what we need to do? In our first click, we need to put our ID inside our state variable. And in our second click, again we will set it back to null, and based on this we will have our conditional rendering. So we have our ID in our hand. So simply we need to put this ID in this active field. So simply set active field. Now here we will have one condition, that is if our active field equal to our ID, then simply set it back to null. Else if it is already null, then set the ID to it. So let me first implement this, then I will show you. And then simply here, instead of plus or maybe minus, we will have our conditional rendering. So it means if your active field is equal to your ID, then simply you will have minus symbol. In the else part, your plus symbol. So let's check. So see, first click, the symbol is getting changed to minus, then again plus, then again minus plus. So we achieved the first thing, right? So then, instead of showing this data, so we need to show this conditionally as well. So simply, here also we will check if our active field is equal to ID, then simply show this data. And here for the button part, we had our ternary operator. It means a minus for the true part and plus for the false part. But here in our active field, we have only one part, that is If this is true, then only show this. Or in the false part, we don't even need this, right? So simply, for the true part, we will show this. So that's why we have here AND operator instead of ternary. So now let's check, then I will show you. So we have our accordion. On my first click, the plus got changed to minus, and simply we have the details, and same for this, and same for this as well. So how it is working? So initially, let's say on our first click, let's say we click this next yes. So we click this, then the onClick event handler comes into play, and the idea of this next yes is simply 1, where we pass the ID as 1, and here we got ID as 1. So as we can see, we have got ID 1 simply. Now here in this condition, so we have ID as 1. So we will check active field equal to ID. So initially our active field is holding null. So the condition that is null equal to our ID. So ID is 1. So this condition is false. So simply it will set the ID to the active field. So now our active field will be holding 1 simply. So as this is compared with ID, so initially active field is holding null, and null is not equal to our ID. Then simply we will set the ID to the active field. So our active field is having 1 now. So now here we will check this active field is equal to ID. So as here we have our ID as 1 simply, and active field is also 1. So here this condition passes. So minus is being shown. So as you can see, and here also for our subdata, we are checking active field is equal to ID or not. So again, active field is 1, ID is also 1. So simply this condition is true, and we will show this. So now let's see the second click part. So if I again click this next yes, simply again we have the ID as 1. So on my second click, again on click comes into play. Here ID is passed. Here we grab the ID, that is simply 1 again. So now again this condition. So this time our active field is already having 1. So now active field is already having 1. So simply 1 equal to ID, which is also 1 this time again. So simply 1 is equal to 1. This condition satisfies. And then for the true part, we have this null. It means now as active field is equal to the ID, we will simply set the active field to null again. So now active field is having null. Then again, here in this condition, active field is equal to ID or not. So this condition becomes false. Now we will have the false part, that is plus, will be shown. So see, again plus. And here in the subdata part, again active field equal to ID or not. So active field is simply null. This condition becomes false. Then again the subdata gets hidden, and the accordion collapses again. So this way it works. So yes, that's it for this video. Hope you understood this in a much better way. So see you all in the next one. Till then, take care.